To take full advantage of a 35mm adapter, we need to have a full understanding of depth of field and the factors that affect it. Simply put, depth of field is the distance in front of and behind the subject, which appears to be in focus. Technically, there is only one distance at which a subject is truly in focus for a given setup. But because the focus falls off gradually, there is still a region extending in front of and behind the true focus distance that appears to be sharp. This region is the depth of field. Anything that is within this region will appear as sharp and in focus, and anything outside of this region will appear as out of focus. Notice that the back portion of the depth of field is larger than the front. The difference between these two portions changes depending on the setup, but in every case, the back portion is larger. Depth of field is most typically referred to as either being shallow or deep, but these terms are often replaced by short and long or small and large. For the purposes of our explanations, we will be using the terms short and long as they seem to cause the least amount of confusion. Having a short depth of field simply means that a smaller range of our scene will be in focus. One of the advantages of using a short depth of field is that it can help to isolate and bring attention to the subject. This is a tool that many portrait photographers use to focus the viewer's attention on the subject and not the surroundings. Having a long depth of field means that a larger range of our scene will be in focus. This allows for more of the scene to be taken in by the viewer,